is joining us for today's plant questions is Carrie Engel of Valley View Farms. Good morning.
Hello.
What did you bring with you?
This is a begonia. This is a rigor begonia. What I love about these is they do great in shade. They do great as a house plant, mm-hmm. or you can put them outside in your shady garden, in window boxes, or wherever you'd like. So it's really one of those plants that works a lot of different places.
Any chance that the cooler weather is going to rebound the tomatoes right now?
I hope so, because mine are looking pretty sad. I was away on vacation, and I have a maple tree a little too close that just sucks all the water right out of that plant.
So unfair.
So it's just, they're coming, but they're slow.
Okay, lots of folks having trouble. We'll go to our first question.
Sure.
I have a line of beautiful hydrangeas whose branches are falling over instead of standing up straight. I can't think of any reason for the change. I cut them back, and they get plenty of rain. Why are they drooping?
You know, check on a couple of different things. One, if you've had a difference in sunlight there, I know I have a tendency to plant trees, and years later, they really outgrow an area. And sometimes those hydrangeas will just sort of be reaching for light. I have that problem in my yard right now. Sometimes it's just that we get the kind of, the heat and everything has really caused plants to just not be at their best, I guess, is the easiest way to do it. What I would do is after this year, go ahead and cut them back. Let them start fresh next year. Most of them will bloom on some older wood next year, and you'll be fine.
Okay, another person wants to know, how can I keep white moths from destroying my collard greens without pesticides?
You can put traps out there, and I don't know many that'll really work, but you can put some of the, like, sticky traps that'll help. The other thing you can use is a product called BT. And BT is a naturally occurring bacillus that just affects cabbage worms and other caterpillar type things. So it unfortunately will also take care of, like, some monarch butterflies if they happen in the area, but they will definitely take care of cabbage worm, and it's probably your safest bet.
Well, somebody else likes their sweet potato so much they don't want to give them up for the winter. So the question is, can a sweet potato vine be kept alive in the winter? I've only grown them outside and now one is blooming.
I don't know. try it inside. You can take, if this is the green sweet potato vine that tries to take over the universe, just go ahead and take some cuttings, put it in some water, put in some soil, and it really should keep going.
Okay, and if you're at a loss for your tomatoes, stop by a produce stand, right?
There you go. There are plenty of good local farmers in the area happy to help.
Sounds great. Carrie, great to see you.
Always good. Thank you.